So let's go back to our class teacher. Right? So we had done at some point this problem of allotting, say, prizes. We want to find the best student or the best three students. So now presumably this job is delegated to the
class
object.
Teacher.
So the object, the class teacher is.
We don't need to know. We'll just
tell,
tell
the class teacher, give us the top three students or give us the top student.
Let's say this is the top student.
Hmm. So then the class teacher has created, we assume, has already got the subject teachers who.
If it's not there, they'll create it.
Yeah, or they have to create it to get the marks.
Okay.
Right? So we have the class teacher as before. And then we have these different teachers, the physics teacher, maths teachers. These are the inside internal objects. So we ask, so we somehow contact this person with a message saying best student.
Okay. So class teacher will say to physics teacher, give me the best student, let us say.
Yeah, so the class teacher will
maybe will ask the physics teacher, chemistry student, teacher, maths chemistry teacher.
Yeah, because we decided that somehow it is some combination of the individual marks and the total marks. So there is some formula.
Something.
Some formula that the class teacher will have.
They figure it out. We don't
decide.
Want to know.
We don't need to know, we just need to know name.
Hmm.
So the class teacher but has to know this. So class teacher might ask maybe the top three in each, because the top student may not appear in, and then do something. So it will ask some information here.
Hmm.
It will ask some information here.
Huh? Okay.
Hmm. And here, but now we have to decide what happened. And then all these will answer.
Hmm.
So this guy will give an answer, this guy will give an answer, this guy will give an answer.
So question here, okay. Now. So what does it do? Class teacher will call physics teacher?
Yeah. And then what? It's like
this is an object, right? So we'll call the physics teacher object to do something, pass it parameters.
And get an answer.
Get an answer. Meanwhile, what is class teacher doing?
Well, so far nothing, right? So this is what we have said, waiting.
So after doing that, it will come back to maths teacher.
Yeah, then wait, maths teacher will come back. Then
so what, well, the physics teacher is doing something.
Maths teacher is idle.
Chemistry teacher is idle.
And the class teacher also idle. So only at any given time, only one of these four guys is working, which is not very, doesn't seem to be a very optimum, efficient way of
using. Works,
yeah,
huh? Real life.
Yeah, that's right.
Because it's not how we do it. Like, you know, class teacher will tell the physics,
exactly.
Chemistry teachers.
Exactly. So
and they will do their job and they will give the result back.
Exactly. We won't be expecting the physics teacher to finish collecting the physics marks, give us the answer. Only
so
then
Monday I call. Monday I call physics teacher, say Monday, physics teacher give me the best student. So I'll wait till end of Monday.
And only
not
then
anything. Then on Tuesday I'll call. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
Same day, Monday itself, I will call physics teacher.
Get
me your best student, chemistry teacher, get me your best student, maths teacher, get me your best student.
Okay, so now
in the evening I'll collect all the marks. It's not very good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Something like that.
So then how, we have to go back to them at some fixed time and say.
But that means what? When I call this physics teacher, I'm not calling, huh? What am I doing now?
Yeah, because I'm not doing what we had said earlier, right? So earlier we said that when we have this kind of a procedure call, right, this is what we do. We kind of say, so we set some x equal to P, A, B, C or something like this if we call, then at this point if we are executing this thing as pseudocode or something, we will come here and then we will wait, right. So this value will be effectively the answer. So we are now waiting, but now supposing we want to proceed, so say this is the physics marks and now I want to ask some question about the maths marks. So we might give some different.
So I want to do one thing, right? I want to, this has too many things going on inside.
Hmm.
I want to unpack it.
Okay.
So one is that first I called PABC.
Hmm.
Then PABC gave me the result.
Yes.
Meanwhile I am waiting.
Hmm.
Then I took the result and put it in X. Can't
yeah.
I separate these two things? I first call PABC.
Yeah.
That I do at one step.
Hmm.
Then I wait.
Hmm.
Then PABC gives me the result. Then I put the result in X. I want to
separate it out into these units.
Because
okay.
The reason I want to do that is because if I call PABC, then I don't have to immediately wait and get the result. I can meanwhile do something. I can call MABC.
Correct, correct, correct.
Huh?
Yeah.
Something like that. That's what goes on real life, no?
Yeah, that's true.
I give the task.
Hmm.
I'm not waiting for the result.
Hmm.
Give the task. Then I go and give the task to somebody else.
Hmm.
Then I give task third person.
And then
maybe
wait
for some.
At some point I have to wait because I don't have any more tasks to do until I get this.
I don't
yeah,
have
I mean I have
tasks.
To wait for all these three to proceed. So there is a.
Then I go back and check with the first guy, are you finished?
Hmm.
He says, no, I'm not finished. Okay. Second guy, are you finished? Like that I can keep doing.
Yeah, so you keep going around, and as one by one they finish, they will give you the answer.
They say, don't keep bothering me, come back after some time. So I wait, okay, I say, okay, I'll come back after 1 hour. After 1 hour, I'll go back and ask this guy, hey, you told me one hour, are you done? 1 hour.
Yeah. No? Correct.
This is the way we do. Normally, this is how we do it.
Yeah.
But this is crazy, huh? Because this is not like procedure call.
Yeah, this is quite different from the way we have been thinking about procedure calls, because we are not getting the answer
immediately.
Not just immediately, it's not that we are holding on until we get each answer and then proceeding to the next step. So we have multiple things happening at the same time. Yeah, at the same time. And so we don't know also whether the maths teacher will return.
So this is the first time you are seeing this. So far, it looked like, so far, there's only one thing that was going on.
Exactly, that's right. So if you ask me what I'm doing, so if I give you some procedure or I give you some complicated computation and I stop it and I ask you now at what stage of the computation are we, then you can tell me we are at this point,
this place
in the computation. And then you can also tell me at this point, these are all the values of
which could be in the main procedure or main thing, or it may be in the procedure.
Yeah, it could be that I've jumped to
call a procedure.
So I have suspended this, come here.
And inside the procedure.
Inside the procedure. And I can take a kind of a snapshot of that and tell you I'm at this place in the code.
So at any given point in time, I'm at exactly one place in the
overall sequence of things I'm planning to do. So I could be going around back and forth, I could be doing iterations and all that, but I'm always at a fixed place.
I know where you are. But here it's not like that here.
Here, yeah, multiple people are active at the same time.
The guy who called, class teacher, is doing something.
Yeah.
He called the physics teacher, gave him a task. Physics teacher started doing something.
Yeah. And math teacher, she is doing something else.
Math teacher doing something else. Chemistry teacher doing something else.
Yeah.
So each of them have their own thing.
Yeah. And they might finish at different times.
So if you ask where in the code are you, or where in the procedure execution are you,
you'll have to point to these
four places.
Four places.
Class teacher will be somewhere, physics teacher will be somewhere.
Yeah.
So there are four places of execution, instead of one.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, in a sense, it depends, on how many of these objects have been activated.
So, this is what parallel, this parallel?
So, it's not really
parallelism.
Parallel, yeah, it is parallel in one sense that things are happening in parallel. But usually, in computation, we distinguish.
Between parallel.
Yeah. So, parallel means that you explicitly tell
four computers are there.
Yeah, four computers. You break up the task into four things which can be done separately and you tell them, okay, you do it.
But in this case, there are four computers, no? Four class teacher, physics, math teacher, in the real life.
Yeah. But
when they are executed on a computer, maybe one computer only may be there.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, for example, supposing I had only one subject like maths. Supposing not the mark, supposing I want the exams corrected. And I had three people there, I could give each of them 1/3 of the exam papers and say, you correct it.
I see.
So now I've broken it up.
The exam papers into three parts.
So I know that the first person's correction is independent. They are marking their papers from beginning to end. It doesn't depend on the second person. So this way I break up the job into three different things, but they're all the same type of thing. So this is usually how we speed up things in parallel, by breaking it up into multiple copies of the same thing. Whereas here actually, okay, now we are asking the physics teacher to compute some best student in physics, math teacher to compute the best student. Now, it may be that in physics there were some experiments, there were some exams, so they might give some weightage to experiments, some weightage. So they might be doing some complicated calculation to figure out that. Maths, there might be a different way of computing the best, may not just be the marks. So they are doing different things and simultaneously. So this is concurrent, I would say, concurrent.
That's what it's called, concurrent.
Concurrent. Concurrent meaning they're happening at the same time, but not necessarily the same thing. They're not doing, they're doing different things, but at the same time.
So concurrency, you call it?
Concurrency, yeah. Concurrency.
Okay. So we have so concurrency means that, unlike what we had earlier where there was only one place, one point of execution, right? One place. Ask the whole thing where you are, you can tell me exactly. Concurrency means that there is not one place. There are multiple
parts are active and each is at a different
point.
So I have to tell you how many things are active and each one. So each one is doing something in a fixed way, but more than one is active.
Bit confusing, huh? Complicated to think about this concurrency.
Yeah,
right?
It's very complicated. I mean, we know in real life also it's complicated, right? So if we ask something to be done, sometimes
we do it all the time, and human beings are right. We are interacting with so many. We are all concurrent only.
Yeah.
Real life is concurrent.
Real life is concurrent. Yes, but the difficulty happens, right? When these two concurrent things interfere with each other somehow. See, here there is no interference, right? The physics teacher is doing something with physics
independently, huh?
Math teacher, so there is nothing really going
to happen.
So the class teacher,
I mean.
Yeah. So the class teacher is the only person who has to collect this information from the three. And the class teacher is only one, right?
But if the physics teacher does something which the math teacher needs,
yeah, then you have a problem, right?
Hey, but here also there is something like the physics teacher has to give the result back to the class teacher, right?
Correct. So now, if that gets confused with
see, I mean, this case it was easy because physics, you know, the class teacher was waiting.
So you know where to get an next answer is going to come from who.
You know, but here.
So yeah, so here, as I said, we discussed one possibility is that you keep asking.
Poll.
Yeah, you poll them, right?
So every so much time, let's say every hour, you go back and ask the physics teacher, chemistry teacher, math teacher.
Yeah. So they don't actually give you the marks until you ask them for it.
Unless you ask them for it.
So you give them time to do their work.
So normally the procedure, when you call the procedure when it finishes, returns the result.
Yeah, it doesn't.
As soon as it finishes, it returns the result.
Yeah, because it knows you are waiting for that. You are kind of stuck.
But here, the physics teacher may have finished, but can't return the result.
Yeah.
Because where do you return the result to?
Yeah, because you don't know where the class teacher has gone off somewhere else.
He's gone somewhere else. So what do you do now? So you basically, when you finish computation,
You sit waiting for
the class teacher to come back.
And ask you for the answer.
Ask you for the answer. Of course, if you are still busy,
yeah, then you will say not done.
Say busy, not done. So it goes away. So you keep waiting till when you finish. You keep waiting now. The procedure keeps.
Procedure waits for the.
Earlier, the class teacher was waiting.
Yeah.
Now the procedure finishes waiting. Actually, yeah. I see. Crazy stuff. This. So the procedure waits, and then the class teacher comes back because it's polling. It's asking. When it comes back and asks me at this time, I'm ready.
If I'm ready, I give it the answer.
I give the answer. Okay. This is a way to make it work. No, but there, I mean, but is it not possible that I finish the procedure, right? I finish the work. Can't I just stop the class teacher? Hey, class teacher, I finished. Here's my result. Take.
Yeah, you could do that. No, so you could tell that person, call me back when you are done. But of course, the problem is that when that person calls you back, you may be doing something else.
Yeah.
You may not.
I want to not like that. I want to basically to call the class teacher. And stop the class teacher from doing what class teacher was teaching, let's say.
Yeah.
I want to stop the class teacher and give my result to him inside the classroom.
Yeah. Which is obviously not something the class teacher may want, depending on.
May not like it, huh?
Yeah.
It's very disturbing to the class teacher. But let us say for a moment I won't do that. Can't I do that?
Yeah, you could do that. But then the class teacher will have to have a way of stopping whatever they're doing. It could be in the middle of doing something important, collecting this answer. And
keeping the answer aside.
Keeping it aside in the appropriate place, like an X or Y or whatever.
Yeah.
And then resuming whatever.
Resuming what they're doing.
So there has to be a way of for the class teacher who's done this calling to be able to interrupt their work and resume the work without losing the thread of what's happening.
So in hardware, we have this interrupt and all that. The same thing, huh?
Yeah, same thing. So there's some normal thing going on, and suddenly you poke it and say, no, stop.
Stop
what you're doing, and this is important.
So this is interrupt. So this is interrupt. So I can interrupt the person and is there a name for this? I mean, in concurrency in our computer science language.
Well, sometimes you call it preemption.
Preempt.
That is you kind of override what they are doing and make them do something else.
So it's preempting them.
Yeah, preempting them.
Preemptive.
Yeah.
Okay. So, we have concurrency and we have this polling. Polling is one method of getting the result. The other way of getting the result is by interrupt, which is preempting.
Yeah, preempting. Yeah.
So, the guy when he finishes, he may stop me, give me the result, I collect the result, keep it aside and continue. Right? Or if he does not allow to stop me, which means I am not allowing this preemption, what do you call it? Preemption. So, if you don't allow me preemption, then the only other method I have is to poll.
Poll, yeah. So he could maybe poll me.
He could poll me also. Either way, I poll him, he polls me.
So he tries to preempt me again little later.
He could poll me, I could poll him, or he could stop me and give me the result. These are two ways.
Hmm.
Okay. So there is, I mean, I've seen also this thing called threads and all that, multiple threads of execution. Is the same thing or?
Similar. So you start something, so you start doing something, and while it is going on, you start something else. And then depending on the situation, you might be waiting for them to finish, or you might be just waiting for them to call you back when they are done.
So you have 3 or 4 or 5 things which are executing simultaneously, like 3, 4 threads, three, four threads, something like that, right?
Yeah. So for the here, the class teacher normally would be in that situation, right? So if you look at it from that thing, so the class teacher starts off these three. So it starts off the physics. So the class teacher is here, right? So it starts off some activity.
It starts the activity
for the physics, maths, and the chemistry teacher.
But doesn't wait for the result. It just starts it.
It just starts it. But now the class teacher
you have four
kind of runs here.
There are four things going on currently now.
Yeah. Okay. But the class teacher, after I've started it, the class teacher may not have anything to do. May or may not.
Okay. Yeah.
So then you are basically waiting for all of these guys to finish.
And at least after the class teacher started physics. They have something to do. They have to create math.
Correct. Yeah. So maybe a better way to think about this is the class teacher going down, and then it sets off this physics guy on this side, right? And then it goes a little further, and then it sets off the maths guy on this side.
Okay.
And then it goes a little further, and sets off the chemistry guy.
Okay. Right?
So the class teacher has done three things, and in the process it has started three new activities which are going on in parallel. And then maybe it is doing something else. Maybe
so it could be three threads.
Something like that. Meanwhile, maybe you are calculating the attendance for the month or something.
Something, it's correct.
And then suddenly this guy will come and preempt. Saying, I've got the answer.
Or you will poll it.
Yeah, or you will, if you run out of things to do, or if you decide you need the answer, you might poll. So either way. Similarly, at some point, this chemistry thing will also. And then it need not be in the same sequence. You started maths first, but you might poll it third. You have some sort of order in which you decide to go back and get the answers. But eventually, these guys will finish, hopefully. And the class teacher will now have the information that they need to give you. Remember, this whole thing started because we asked for the best.
Best student,
So the
class teacher has to return back to us.
Yeah, has to finally.
Well, we are also concurrently have done that. We have asked the class teacher to do something, we are doing something else.
Exactly. So the same preemption polling happens. So we might ask the class teacher, have you finished? I mean, have you got the answer or no?
Poll or the class teacher when he finishes may preempt.
So you might tell the class teacher, I have to print a certificate now, you have to give me the name by tomorrow. So quickly. And meanwhile, we might be doing our own thing, right? So
okay.